celebrating God the way I would have loved you to do. March, that is the third month, there's no doubt about it. January, gone completely. February, completely gone. But now March, and you are witnessing it. Lift up your voice one more time. Say, God, I thank you this morning. Say, Jehovah, I glorify your holy name for bringing me into the new month of March. Father, be exalted. Turn into prayer or praise in the name of Jesus. Lord, I glorify your holy name. Daddy, I thank you this morning. I glorify your holy name. I exalt your big name. Father, be exalted in the name of Jesus. It's not by power, it's not by might, but by thy spirit, says the Lord of hosts. I thank you because you are the one that brought me in. It's not anyone. It's not the righteousness of my hands. It's not because I am serving in a level that is greater than others. It's because you are so merciful. You have shown another mercy, even unto me this morning, to have been a living soul. March 1st, 2018. Father, be exalted. Lord, be glorified in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for answered prayers. In Jesus' great name, we have praise. I'd like you to speak to God in praise one more time. That you have given me March 1st, 2018. I know you will give me till 31st March 2018. I know you will give me beyond. I know even at the end of this year, I will not even still die. I know I will go beyond this year. Shall we praise the name of the Lord one more time, ladies and gentlemen? Lord, I am thanking you. If you can give me January, February, and you can give me March, I know it's possible you can also give me April. I know you will give me May. I know you will give me even June and July. I know August you will give to me as well. I know September you will grant unto me. I know October you will give unto me. I know November, December you shall give unto me as well. I know even beyond I shall be alive. Hail and hearty. Oh God, be celebrated this morning. Oh God, be glorified this very morning. Father, I appreciate you. I appreciate your goodness and your power. Even over my life and that of my family. Even my work, Father, I thank you. In Jesus' name, we have praised. How many children of God? Say amen in the house. Our Father, be exalted in the name of Jesus. You have brought us again into the new month. Lord, we are not taking it for granted. We know a day is a very big arrangement. Talking about just 24 hours, because anything can happen. Father, be glorified in the name of Jesus. How many of the 24 hours have you given to us? Several. 31 in January, 28 in February. Oh God, be glorified in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, this morning. Be exalted in the name of Jesus. As we go into the month, go with us in the name of Jesus. Very briefly, we want to speak to the lives of your children. Open up the gate of word right now in the name of Jesus. In abundance, pour upon them in the name of Jesus. Whether they are directly under this voice or they are hearing from the internet, Lord, let your word manifest in their lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you for answering the prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Eyin Oluwa. Let somebody be seated. Please make yourself as comfortable as possible this morning. We don't have too many people in the house, at least physically. So you may not even need to sit where you are. You may desire to go to sit in some other places. If you think that somebody is sitting beside you and you are not having the comfortability that you desire, just leave that place. Go to places where people are not even sitting down. So that about 4 chairs, you alone can occupy one of them and you'll be a king there. And I decree this morning in the name of Jesus, it looks like a play. But before we end the 31 days, the Lord will have changed your status in the name of Jesus. It looks like just the pastor is just trying to lift up our voice or lift up our spirit. But I tell you this and I declare concerning you that this is the month you will take over in the name of Jesus. I'm also assuring you by the grace of God upon my life that the 31 days of this month, the Lord said to me, I shall announce to every soul that till the end of the month, you will be receiving miracles in the name of Jesus. That is from the early part of the month which we are now. Heaven shall open unto you in the name of Jesus. The Lord said, I shall announce until 31st March, 12 midnight, you will be receiving miracles in the name of Jesus. I want you to register this in your mind and I want you to put it down in black and white if possible. And I know that by April, you will come and give your testimonies. In the morning like this, April 1st, 2018, some of you will come and will say at the dot of 11:30 p.m., at the dot of 12 midnight, just a minute to 12 midnight, I receive this in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you shouting your amen, ladies and gentlemen? Can you rise up on your feet and say, God, I receive all this this morning? Can you rise up to say, everything you are bringing my way in the month of March, I shall receive in the name of Jesus. And so shall it be unto you in the name of Jesus. Put your hands together to celebrate God one more time. This morning, I'm not going to do much of sermon because I have discovered that the time is not there. But honestly, I have a lifting in my heart, maybe you will say as usual. And I began to wonder, I began to look at so many things, and it was so clear in my heart that the Lord will make the month of March 2018 a special month for you. I tried as much as possible to gather some points to justify that. I'm going to share one or two of them with you. But it was so heavy upon me that if you have spent January, you have passed through February, and you are going into the third month, knowing that third or three is something so special, I decree in the name of Jesus. Because we talk about Trinity, the God of Father, the God of Son, the God of the Holy Spirit. And you don't complete it until you get to the God of the Holy Spirit. And you are talking about one in three, three in one. You are talking of a package that is inseparable. You are talking of a package that has been in existence even before existence is there. You are talking about a package that works wonders at all times. So I was heavy in my spirit. And I rose up. And I said, in this month, Lord, make it special month. Unto every son, every daughter that you have in restoration prophetic ministries in the mighty name of Jesus. Whether that son or daughter is physically with us here, or the daughter is linking up anytime, it shall be so in the name of Jesus. Child of God, your amen was very weak. Child of God, your amen was very weak. That amen was still very weak. So I began to look at it and God was giving me quite a lot of declarations. And that is what we are going to start with this morning. Register it in your hearts. Lay your heart unto it. That this month is coming with something special unto you. Mark it in your diary. That the Lord is having something special for you in the month of March. Mark it in your January, in your February, in your March. Mark it. You will have something greater in the name of Jesus. That as the Lord liveth and his spirit lives, this is the month that you will never forget in the name of Jesus. You didn't shout the amen very well. You will possess. Your possessions, you will possess. Your lost possessions, you will possess. The possession somewhere that does not belong to you, you will possess. God will make you to take over. You know, last week, was it last week or even before that time, I said, God just told the Israelites, said, I've prepared a place for you. Long time he said it to them. Then he kept reminding them. 400 years, they are forgotten. 438 years, he told them, he said, I still remember, I promise my friend, your father, and I'm going to take you there. And you and I will feel that such a person will be a virgin land. A land that is going to be like a thick forest. Then you have to bring caterpillar and some other things to come and do kind of bulldozing and getting the preps prepared. But it was not like that. Some people were already there. They have tilted the land. They have removed the trees, the mahogany and everything. They have constructed the land. In fact, they have built houses. And the Lord just said, move in. And they took over. Ladies and gentlemen, you will take over. He just moved them there. He said, arise. It was a midnight. He said, move now. Because that place has been waiting for you. I reason in my spirit that you have some possessions. You don't know where they are. I also reason in my spirit that you know where some are, but you cannot get there. I reason in my spirit that you know that some people, they are sitting at the top of your inheritances. And you have nothing to do against them because you are weak. So I decree in March 2018, you will take over in the name of Jesus. Say in the name of Jesus. You are not saying it. You are not saying it well. In the month of March, lay your right hand upon your chest so that God will know that you are talking to yourself. So that you yourself will know you are talking to yourself. The Lord said to me, he said, well, I have given you this since December 2017. He said, you need to bring it up now. And you need to go to the scriptures. You need to bring out as many verses and portions of the Bible where I made my people to take over. And you need to declare it concerning them. And I would look at all those ones and I will make it happen. Say in the name of Jesus. Only half of the class said it. Say in the name of Jesus. Say in the month of March 2018, I and my household, we shall possess. We shall possess our possession. And finally, we shall take over that which you have prepared for us. Can you turn it to a glorious prayer? Lift up your voice and pray. Let your right hand be on your chest. It's a sign that yes, it is this individual. It is this individual that is you that desire this in prayer. You are agreeing with God Almighty that what is bringing unto you through his servant, you are accepting it because you love it and that it will come to pass in your life. Shout it, I will take over. I know my possessions are there. I know my inheritances are somewhere. I know you have prepared some seats for me. God, let me take over in the name of Jesus. Add in the month of March, please. Say in the next 31 days. O God of heavens and the earth, I shall take over. I shall take over. I shall take over in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, I know the place is waiting for me. I know that status is waiting for me. I know that office is waiting for me. Oh God, I will take over. Say it many, many times. Say it many, many times. Don't be weak in your spirits. Don't be weak physically. I like you to gain more strength. Each time you say it, each time it is said on concerning you, say, I shall take over in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Oh God, see what the Lord is showing to me in the book of Psalm 23. Verse number 5, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. And in their presence, you anointed my head with oil. In their presence, my cup runneth over. So I am standing to decree concerning you that anywhere, everywhere, you will take over in the name of Jesus. In the prying eyes of your heart enemies, you will take over. And I want to confirm to you this morning that other brothers of David, they were not his friends. I don't know whether I will have time to tell you this and to discuss it with you much better. They were not his friends. They were older, but they were not his friends. But in their midst, the Lord anointed him as king. He was the least. That was another anointing in the presence of one's enemies. Child of God, I don't know where your inheritance are, but anywhere they are, you will take over in the name of Jesus. Let me assure an individual this morning, when the Lord does his works in your life, a lot of people, they may not be comfortable with it. When Samuel came with Saul, when he announced Saul unto people, the Bible recorded that there were some people, they said, this man cannot become our king. But they had nothing to do against it. Saul still reigned. You will reign in the name of Jesus. The Bible called them dissenting voices. They will be everywhere. You can't have 100% acceptability. It's not possible. Except you are not a candidate of God. A candidate of God most of the time cannot be popular. It's always a minority. Oh, I know you are a minority, but God is choosing you in the mighty name of Jesus. I know you don't know and you don't have what it takes to become what God is making you to be. But because you are his candidate, he shall enhance you in the mighty name of Jesus. You know why God does one of the things he does most of the time. If you are too knowledgeable, he will know that you'll be saying that it is because I am a knowledgeable individual. If you are too much a person in terms of experience, he will not want to appoint you into an exalted place because you will be counting on your experience. So he will go to look for people like you and I who are non-entity, who are nobody, and he will place them higher and higher. That is what he's going to do for you in the name of Jesus. As you are still having your hand on your chest, I'd like you to decree concerning your life. Say, I decree in the name of Jesus. Say, I decree in the name of Jesus. Say, I decree in the name of Jesus that in March 2018, I shall take over. Turn it to prayer in the name of Jesus. I shall take over. You are not praying now, but you are decreeing. Say, I decree that I will take over. Say, I declare prophetically that I will get there by fire and by force. Say, the hand of the angels shall take me there in the name of Jesus. Say, the zeal of God Almighty shall mash me into that exalted position of my life in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have decreed. I didn't hear your amen. The Lord asked me to tell you, never mind, never mind. He looks for people like you. He goes to the harsh heap. People who are nobody. I was listening to a message of when David was the captain of people who are distressed, who are in debt, who are displeased, who are displaced. And the man of God said, well, he's a loving thing, but captain is a captain. He was captain of people who were nobody. But when the Lord turned their captivity, they became mighty men and women of valor. So I decree in the name of Jesus, you will take over. You know what the Lord is registering in my heart, and you are going to pray with it now. That over all my troubles, over all my trials, over all my tribulations, over all my reproaches, over all my shame, I will take over. How many of you lift up your voice and pray? Over all my debts, over my disappointments, over my disillusionments, over my diseases, I am taking over in the name of Jesus. I shall take over. My shame, I am announcing unto you. My reproaches, I am announcing unto you. Every debt, I am announcing to you that here I come to take over. Oh God, I have the commission to take over. I have the word to take over. I have the declaration to take over. I have the instruction to take over. Oh God, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You know what the Lord is showing me? I have seen some of you. You are going to the headquarters. And the headquarters, you know what you have gone to do there. You are going to collect letters from the superior authority to go to a location and take over. Shout your amen. I said the Lord was showing, he's showing to me why the prayer is going on. I saw you rushing to the headquarters to collect letters of authority. They don't need to know you that place. The letters will identify you. You didn't shout your amen. You say, I am from the headquarters. I have a letter here. And the letter reads, this man or this woman will captain this place. You are the one in the name of Jesus. Your hand lifted up, one right hand. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I receive it this morning. Shout it one more time, I receive it. Shout this morning, I receive it. One more time, I receive it. One more time, I receive it. One more time, I receive it. In the name of Jesus. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Put your hands together for the Lord. Be seated. Oh God, so many things here. Oh, glory be to God Almighty. All right, we're going to continue. Thank God tomorrow is our vigil. And I want you to come to that vigil because it's going to be very serious. Like I said unto us, he said, I have given you this word since December 2017. Yes, fulfillment has started. People have been coming to give such testimonies. People have been bringing their letters where they are taking over. And I'm not going to lie to you. Few of them, you know. All right? So, but God said that I want to do in a massive form. And he said to me, turn into something that will be rolling on every day. So that it will come in terms of declarations. It will come in terms of teaching from the word of the Lord. It will come. People will be disturbed with it. Even the kingdom of darkness will be disturbed with it. That there is a candidate here that is going to take over. You didn't shout your amen. So the Lord said, I should announce to you and I should announce to the whole world. And every day I should be sending signal to every position of authority that members of Restoration Chapel are coming. You are not shouting amen. And every morning I will announce everywhere that there are positions of authority for members of Restoration Prophetic Ministries. If the position is not vacant, the Lord said I should declare it vacant. Anywhere around the globe, And as I declare it vacant, it becomes vacant in the name of Jesus. You are taking over from unbelievers. And the Lord said, as I declare those thrones and those positions and inheritances vacant, then I should declare you there. Thank God it's month of March. The Lord will push you there. The Lord will march you there. You are marched out of your poverty. You are marched out of your indolence. You are marched out of your ignorance. You are marched into your place of authority. You are marching there to take over. You are marching there to possess. You are marching there to collect what belongs to you in the name of Jesus. Oh, the angels of the Lord are marching you there. They are marching you there. They are marching you there. They are marching you there. In the name of Jesus. They are marching you to fulfillment. They are marching you to the word of the Lord. They are marching you to take over. One more time, shout your amen. Finally, I'd like to read just one portion of the Bible unto you. Please go back and sit down. I know the Lord has already lifted your spirit up, and you will not be disappointed in the name of Jesus. You didn't shout that amen very well. Shout it one more time in the name of Jesus. Shout it one more time in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Say, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Say, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Say, I receive it in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Go with me to the book of Genesis chapter 41. Sorry, the time is not there. I have several portions to read, but let's look at this. Verse 40 says, thou shalt be over my house, and according unto thy word shall all my people be ruled. Only in the throne will I be greater than thou. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, see, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh took off the ring from his hand and put it upon Joseph's hand, and arrayed him in a vestures of fine linen, and put a gold chain about his neck. And he made him to ride in the second chariot which he had. And they cried before him, bowed the knee, and he made him ruler over all the land of Egypt. That is your portion this month. Rise up on your feet. Let us close. Just one prayer point in 1 minute. Whatever is going to stop me from taking over, remove it this morning. Your sin can prevent you. Your sin can prevent you. Your iniquity can prevent you. You are loading so many things in your heart. Negativity can prevent you. So quickly pray. 1 minute. Anything, everything that will prevent me from taking over. Father, remove this money. Turn it to prayer in the name of Jesus. Remove. This money, remove. Your stinginess unto God's work can prevent you. Your true no can prevent you. Say, oh God, whatever would not allow me to take over as prophesied concerning my life, remove it this morning. Remove it this morning. Remove it totally. Now, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Bring up.